डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
वेलकम टू डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई प्रीति बसेर वेलकम यू एट द चैतन्य स्टूडियो इन द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट डिप्लोमा इन साइबर सिक्योरिटी फॉर द सब्जेक्ट PGDCS 203 एप्लीकेशन एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड यूनिट ऑफ ब्लॉक 1। इट इज़ ऑल अबाउट प्रोग्रामिंग बग एंड मालिशियस कोड। टुडे मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजी हैज़ बिकम एन इनसेपरेबल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ आवर लाइव्स एंड इट इज़ डिफिकल्ट टू थिंक ऑफ वर्ल्ड विदाउट इट। हाउएवर द एडवांसमेंट इन द टेक्नोलॉजी ऑल्सो कम विद रिस्क, especially in the terms of malicious code that threaten the health of computer systems. So in this lecture we are going to talk about programming bugs and malicious code. If you understand how malicious code operates, you can be step ahead in containing it and removing it. So guys, let us start the agenda slide. Today's agenda of today's lecture is all about introduction, programming bugs, classifying bugs, impacts of programming bugs, different types of programming bugs, types of unusual programming bugs, examples of programming bugs, process to be zero bug programmer, malicious code, types of malicious code, and at the end classification of malware. So let us start discussing the introduction slide. Software bug or a programming bug is a fault in computer program that produces the incorrect or unexpected results. These bugs are generally the result of mistakes made by the programmer, either in the design or source code. Some are caused by compiler that generated invalid code. The program that contains large number of bugs is said to be a buggy or defective program. In software development life cycle, during the projects, a mistake or a fault may be introduced at any stage during the development stage. They arise from the oversight or mutual misunderstanding made by the software team during the specification, design, coding, data entry, and documentation. For example, if in creating relatively simple program to sort the list of words into the alphabetical order, one's design might fail to consider what should happen when the word contains hyphen. Some bugs have only subtle effect on the programs. Some bugs have only subtle effect on the program's functionality and thus lie undetected for a long time. More serious bug can cause program to crash or freeze. Malicious code is an application security threat that cannot be efficiently controlled by conventional antivirus software alone. Malicious code describes the broad category of system security terms that includes attack scripts, viruses, worms, backdoors, and malicious active content. In this unit, we will discuss about the programming bugs and malicious code. So now let us see what is programming bug. The Webster's Collegiate Dictionary defines A bug is an unexpected defect, fault, flaw or imperfection. There is a most popular story. Grace Bure Hopper discovered that the Harvard Mark II computer was producing inaccurate answers. When she examined the machine more closely, trying to locate the problems, that she found that a squash moth which was caught between the contact of electromechanical relay and it was preventing relay from fully closing. The first computer bug has been introduced. In fact, she extracted that moth with a pair of tweezers and tapped it into the operator's logbook with the comment like that, the first actual bug found, implying that the term was already in use that time. So the term bug had become popular in programming language. So to save the egos of programmer who could not admit their programs were full of errors, instead they used to prefer to say that their programs had a bug in them. Programming bugs are hard to find, and although the located bug is frequently easy to fix, it is difficult to ensure that all bugs have been removed from the program. Debugging is an activity of locating and removing the errors from the programs. Now we will see how to classify the bug. The classifications of bug have been given here in the slide. It has been classified in 5 broad categories, such as token error, syntax constraint error, execution error and intent error. Let us discuss each one of them in detail. First one is the token error. Token error, when the token is available in the programming token is not available in the programming language dictionary, right? For example, whenever program contains a word or a symbol that is not available in programming language dictionary. For understanding purpose, let us take an example. Suppose that we are standing in the street in San Francisco and we are asked by the lost motorist. He asks, how can I get to the Portland, Oregon? The motorist is unable to follow our instruction because he is unable to understand some of the words from which the instructions have been composed. Right? Same way, the compiler must recognize each and every token and identifier, symbol, literal and comments in our program. Next one is the syntax error. Syntax error is one kind of another kind of category of the programming bugs. We can say that when the compiler recognizes each and every token in a program, even though program still contains syntax error. This type of error occurs when we use incorrect grammar or punctuation. Right. So, going back to our previous example of the lost motorist, we might reply that for keep 100 miles going 8 just. Here each word and token is individually recognizable as a correct English, but we have combined them in a senseless and convoluted manner. So, the parts of speech are not in their correct position for a English grammar. So, that is why we are having such kind of syntax error in our program. Right. Now, next one is the syntax constraints error. Syntax constraint error occur when the compiler cannot determine the meaning of program. Suppose that we have told the motorist keep going for 800 just mile. Technically, this sentence is syntactically correct, but the phrase just mile is meaningless. So, once again, the motorist would not be able to understand fully what we have told to him. So if program contains any syntax tokens or syntax constant error, this is called compiler time error, right? So the compiler will discover them, and in all three cases compiler has no idea what we mean to say. So it will not try to correct the error, it will simply report the error in the form of errors and warning window, and would be able to finish the compiling program. So all these errors, such as token, syntax error, syntax constant error, are called as compile time errors, because the compiler detects them while compiling our program. We can link and run the program only when the program is successfully compiled. That means it has no compile time error. Error that occur when the program is running or it is executing are called runtime error. Since the compiler point out the compile time error that are easy to fix, so we can definitely fix our the compilation error, right? But now the next one type of error, that is called as a execution error, right? So execution error occurs when the runtime system is executing the program and discovers that it won't be able to handle our instruction, right? So for example, division by zero in our program, right? Divide by zero, such kind of error cannot be handled, right? So in such situation, it terminates the execution of the program by supplying some information about the error. Returning to our motorist example, trying to get from the San Francisco to Portland, we might tell him just keep going for the 800 miles. But if he is facing in the west direction at that time, and interprets our instruction literally, he could travel only few miles before reaching to the Pacific Ocean. At this point, he would stop and realize that he could not complete the instruction. This illustrates the execution error. Execution errors are often called as a runtime error because the runtime system environment can detect them only when it tries to execute or run the program. Now, next go to the intent error. Final error class is the most insidious because neither compiler nor runtime can detect this type of error when it occurs. An intent error occurs whenever the program successfully completes its execution, but the program does not compute the correct result. So coming back to our previous example, our motorist who is trying to reach to Portland from the San Francisco, we would again tell him just keep going the 800 miles. But if he is facing to the south direction, he could successfully carry out our instruction, but he would end up with Tijuana, Mexico, not a Portland, Oregon. Remember that the execution environment understand what we intend to do with them. It knows how to compile, how to link and execute the instruction that we have given to it. There is no way for it to know what we intend the program to do. Frequently, the intent errors early in our programs and then later lead to the execution error. In such cases, the error becomes manifest at location that is different than the source of error. Thus, we must carefully hand simulate our programs either from the beginning or backward from the execution error or end of program to locate incorrect instruction. Now let us see, this is the code for have been given to you. There are two for loops. Now in this for loop, there are two for loops. First one outer for loop and the second is the inner for loop, right? In the outer for loop, I increments, right? I variable increments, and for the inner for loop, j variable increments, right? Now you can see there are some of the second instruction have been given, right? In this code, it is ended with the semicolon, right? So such kind of error have been caused by the stray character. That is, we call it as a semicolon on the second line. While minor in this fix, they can be a devil to find, right? So compiler will not give any error, but we may be a victim for the bugs, right? Now let us go for next. We will see what are the impact of programming bugs. The impact of programming bugs tends to vary and could have wide range of impact on the software end user. Some are very simple, such as your word editing program that might take little extra time for loading. Others are more serious and may cause the application to freeze and crash when the performing certain actions, right? So in this scenario, you normally receive an error message briefly detailing the problem. You also have the worst type of programming bugs, which qualify as a security vulnerabilities. These are typically flaws with your operating system or a web browser. Such deficiencies could open exploit for the intruder and malicious software writer and can give them the control of system. While programming bugs themselves are not malicious, they can be very dangerous. The computer software industry has taken the note of these strides to become more efficient at the development. Some of these measures include following. The first one is the programming style. The programming style that you are using, right? So programming bug often appears when the logical errors are made. The programming styles are intended to make this error less likely and easier to notice. Second one is the programming techniques. Bugs generally cause the problem by creating inconsistency within the data of running application. Various techniques are employed to immediately hold the program when the inconsistencies are encountered. This is a quick procedure that enables bug to be identified and fixed. Other methods involve attempting to correct bug while allowing the program to continuously run. And the last one, that is the language support. The language being used is essentially the base of all programming bugs. Many programming languages these days come up with equipped features that help the programmers effectively handle flaws and common errors. One such function is the exception handling. Additionally, some of these newer languages have purposely excluded these features that are more liable to lead to programming bugs. For instance, a popular programming Java programming language does not support the functions such as pointer arithmetic. Okay, so now let us see different types of programming bugs here. We will discuss each one of them in detail. Arithmetic bug. Arithmetic bugs occurs due to several reasons. The first one is the division by zero, right? Divide by zero error, right? So you must have come across such kind of error in your program, right? The next one is the arithmetic overflow or underflow condition, right? So, and the last one is the loss of addition inaccurateness as an after effect of rounding absurdly or a numerically ambiguous algorithm. Next one is the logic bugs. Computer programming bugs such as infinite loop. You are writing a code like as a infinite loop. This bug can crash your system, right? Okay. And if you are using the absolute formula, again you can have such kind of bugs in your code, right? Next one is the syntax bug. Syntax bugs in error in the system, the code of application. It is small grammatical mistake can be done in it can be done in any one symbol, right? So compiler provides the information about such bugs when the code is compiled, and the developer can fix them very quickly. Then the resource bug. Resource bugs are caused by different reason. First one is a null error dereference. Then using uninitialized variable. Then the third one is the access violation. Fourth one is the resource leak, such as memory leak situation. Or memory is leaked when the objects present in the heap that are no longer used, but the garbage collector is unable to remove these objects from the memory, and thus they are unnecessarily maintained. A memory leak is bad because it blocks memory resources and degrades the system performance over a time. And if not dealt with, the application will eventually exhaust its resources and finally terminating with the fatal error. The next one is a buffer overflow. Buffer overflow condition exists when the program attempts to put more data in buffer than it can hold. One more thing is that multi-threading programming bugs, right? These kind of bugs occurs due to the deadlock situation and race condition. The deadlock situation occurs where a task can't continue until A can't continue until task B finish, and at the same time B can't continue until the task A finishes. Another problem with the multi-threading bugs is race condition, right? One more categorization of the this bug is called as a interfacing bug. Interfacing bug occurs due to the incorrect use of API, incorrect agreement implementation, incorrect accountments handling, incorrect assumptions of code platform. Now let us go ahead the types of unusual programming bugs. Why some programming bugs are simple and easy to find and others are very much complex and difficult to find? Unusual software bugs refer to the class of programming bugs that flows programming bugs that are extremely difficult to both comprehend and repair. There are several types primarily named after historic scientists who introduce the theories and personify their strange behavior. These are Schrödinger bugs, Heisenberg bugs, Born bugs, and Mendel bugs. Let us discuss each one of them in detail. The first one, the Schrödinger bugs. Schrödinger bug is a classification of unusual software bugs. It is unusual software bug. This type of bug This type of bug is one that goes unnoticed until the programmer or other person reads the software code and discovers that the programmer never should been able to work in the first place. In the discovering the Schrödinger bug, the bug manifests and the program will no longer function until the bug has been fixed. The name Schrödinger bug is from the Schrödinger's cat thought experiment in the quantum physics in 1935. Erwin Schrödinger proposed the famous thought experiment in which the cat was somehow both alive and dead at the same time. So this is one of the classification of the unusual programming bugs. The first one we have seen, Schrödinger bugs, right? Now the next one is the Hazen bug, the classification of Hazen unusual programming bug. The Hazen bug is a software bug that changes or alters its behavior when it's being observed or undergoes isolation. Hazen bug can refer to any software bug with unusual behavior, particularly when its operation appears to disappear or changes when it is being studied by the software program or debugger application. This type of bug is often the result of race condition, right? So in this we have seen the Schrödinger bug, right? Hazen bug we also seen. Schrödinger bug and okay. Now the next one is the Born bug. The Born bug is an unusual software bug that consistently makes its presence known under the condition that are either well defined, possibly unknown, or both. Unlike Hazen bug, the Born bug does not hide or modify the characteristics when the research is performed. This makes the errors much easier to fix, yet it is harder to locate it. This type of software bugs may remain in the software all the way during the operational stage. Now the next one is the Born bug received its name from the Bohr atom model proposed by Niels Bohr in 1913. Now the next one type of unusual bug, it is called as a Mendel bug, right? So this unusual software bug is named after Bernhard Mandelbrot, a fractal innovator of the early 90s. Mendel bug is a programming bug with such level of complexity that its behavior appears to be malicious. The term is often used to refer to a bug whose behavior does not appear malicious but has such high level of complexity that it appears to be no practical solution. The prime example of this kind of bug have been generated bug generated from the error in the fundamental design of entire operating system, right? So in today's lecture we have seen Schrödinger bugs, Hazen bug, Born bug, Mendel bug, and in detail, right? Now let us see the examples of programming bug. So this is called as a exceed. Here the code has been given to you, right? There is a two for loop, okay? Outer for loop and inner for loop. In this we have pixel variable is getting incrementing, right? Okay. Now in the second line of code, right? Such kind of error does not come under notice. Even some compiler does not show the warning or error messages. It considers, right? So this kind of bug is called as an accidental bug, right? So these accidental bugs are often caused by the stray characters, right? As we have seen in the second line, we have unknowingly being using the semicolon, right, in the for loop, okay? So this minor in it is very much minor for their fixing, but they can be a devil to find. It's very difficult to find this error. Missing or improper initialization. You can see here the minimum value. This function indicates the minimum to find out the minimum from the array, right? Here we can see the variable current min is not initialized, right? So some compiler has a capability to identify if the variables they have not been initialized, right? So it show, otherwise it may ignore, and compiler will initialize such kind of variables by default value, right? But it is hard to find out such kind of error than the missing one, right? And you will get the unexpected result at the same time. Then dyslexics. Here this program is all about finding the minimum value, right? So here you can see the program has used the greater than, right? It is using the greater than symbol for comparing the elements of the array with this current min variable, okay? So it keeps unnoticed to the development sites, right? And it gives an unexpected result, right? And the people who are not normally dyslexic are subject to this type of error, right? Then the next one is a miscopy bug. Here you can see the switch cases. In this switch case we have four cases: case 1, case 2, case 3, case 4. In case 1 we are doing something, case 2 something 2, right? Case 3, it is copied from the case 1, right? So unnecessary cases are getting copied here, right? Under case 3 the values are not changed as appropriate for the case, right? So code reuse is good, but this form of code of copying has its own danger, and the programmer are not aware about such kind of bugs, right? Then the last one, next one is the accidental error, accidental bug. Here there in code there is a two statement, right? If condition and the second one is the we are using foo, we are initializing. There are two bugs in one. These are usually caused by the accident rather than misunderstanding. The equal sign of line 1 should be probably double equal, and the double equal sign of line 2 should be always certainly be equal. Neither of this statement is syntactically wrong, and many compiler will warn about both of these. But although such kind of accident error can cause the programming bugs, right? Then the next one is the abuse global bugs. This program illustrates some fun with the global or local variables. In function foo, j is a local and I is a global. Since I is being used as a local variable, this is almost certainly wrong. Making j local here may or may not be logically correct, but it is certainly incorrect since the semantic meaning of j is being used in two different ways, right? So in main, j is a local, so when it gets set by call to foo, the global value is not being set, so need is out of luck the value, and this value is still undefined. So the moral is that if variable is global, never use that name for anything else. Now the next one for it is all about the process to be zero bug programmer. Never start coding unless you have ambiguous specification for functionality. A good programmer should be able to ensure that a code he or she changes is reliable, correct, and thoroughly self-verified. One should completely understand all the results and the impact on changes will cause. Some users have tried to their best to be a good programmer by testing again and again, but the bugs are still there. That's the only way you can be a zero programmer, zero bug programmer. Here are some steps to make a bug-free program. First one, that is, never start coding unless you have ambiguous specification for your functionality, right? So if you are not clear with the definition or its functionality, right? So don't start coding, right? Do not test, or if you do not rely on testing to catch the defects in the software, right? So if testing softwares are not reliable, so it is our general advice that don't test it, right? Then the apply all feedbacks from the defects that we have discovered during the testing phase, right? So whatever the feedbacks we are getting, right, in, during the testing phase, we have to consider it, right? Discard all defective components completely as soon as the defects are found. We need to discard all the defective components completely. Then update your checklist. Update your checklist and retrain your developers so that they don't make mistakes like that again, right? So you have to make sure that such kind of errors are repeatedly coming, right? And for that you have to make some checklist, right? And you have to train your developers, right? So that whenever such kind of bugs or errors comes, right, they should be taking care while developing the projects or program, right? Testing can only prove that you have bugs, but it is usually useless to prove otherwise. Bugs are unavoidable because the programmers are human. If we all can do is try our best to prevent them. Zero bug programmer is an oxymoron. It is an oxymoron like a silent singer. The characteristic which will make you a better programmer that are as follows. We have to be humble. You are and you will be making mistakes repeatedly, be fully aware about the limited size of code. Fight the combinatorial explosion. You have to fight with the combinatorial explosion. Get rid of changeable state and learn programming functionality. Reduce number of possible codes, code path, right? Whatever the paths are there, right? You have to reduce accordingly. Understand the size of input and output spaces, right? And try to reduce them in order to get ever closer to 100% test coverage, right? So these are the things we have to follow. Always assume that your code is not working, prove it otherwise, right? So in this lecture we have discussed about various functionality software bug and programming bug, right? We have seen different types of bugs, unusual bug, usual bug also, different Hazen bug, okay. So I hope you must have understood this lecture. See you in the next lecture. Thank you very much.